In continuous with the previous video of Bedford chord view, in which we have understood an ordinary Bedford chord structure, now we are taking a modification of this, and that is known as wedded Bedford chord. In this Bedford chord, we are introducing some of the wedding ends. So some thick wedding ends are introduced, which lie between the rib face cloth and the weft floats on the underside to give greater prominence to the chords. And how wedding ends are introduced? Wedding ends are up where the picks float at the back, and wedding ends are down where the picks view in plain order. What does it mean? Try to understand it. Here you can understand it with the sectional diagram of plain face Bedford chord view. Thick wedding ends are introduced which lie between the rib face cloth. This is plain face, which is also known as rib face. So these are the rib, this is the rib face of the fabric, and this is again another rib face of the fabric. These are two chord structures. So here this will remain up and this will remain up on the wedding ends. So wedding ends lie between the rib face cloth, means this is rib face, this is plain face. So wedding picks lie here just above the floating threads, floating picks, where the picks are floating at the back, they are up, and where the picks are interwoven in plain order, they are below those picks. So these ends are up on the floating picks and these ends are below this plain face texture. So position of wedding ends will be here in this portion and here in this portion. That is the meaning of this paragraph. And how we have to indicate them in the view: wedding ends are up where the picks float at the back, and wedding ends are down where the picks float and the picks view in plain order. That will be clear from one example. So for example, we are taking a wedded Bedford chord in 20x4. On the same basis, we are taking this wedded Bedford chord. Here we have 16x4. So I am introducing two wedding ends in the first chord and two wedding ends in the next chord. Number of wedding ends can be introduced according to our choice or according to our requirement, because wedding ends are used to increase the prominence of chord structure. So if we want to increase the prominence more, then we will insert more wedding ends, and if you want to decrease it, we will reduce. So an optimum number in this repeat, we are taking two wedding ends. Sometimes you can introduce only one. So generally we introduce in one chord structure only two wedding ends. So here, if you see, the design is of 16x4, and the arrangement was one plane, six chord, two plane, six chord, and one plane. Similarly, here I am taking one plane, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 chord, again 2, 4, 6 chord, and plane. So the arrangement of the plane ends and chord ends is same as plain face Bedford chord, which we have already taken in the previous video. Only what we are doing, we are introducing wedding ends at a particular place in the design. So here, in a symmetrical manner, before, after these two chord ends, I have introduced one wedding, and before these two chord, I have introduced one wedding. Similarly, after two chord ends of the alternate chord, one wedding, and before two chord, one wedding. So in this way, we are introducing wedding ends in a symmetrical manner, which will give better look to the fabric. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4 ends are added for wedding purpose. So 16x4, it will become 20, and picks will remain same as the previous design, that is 4 picks. Now the method of construction will be almost same, except inserting the wedding ends or introducing the wedding end. So here plain view, so in the same manner you can indicate the plain view here. So just assume that wedding ends are absent, these vertical spaces are absent, and indicate the same design which we have taken for plain face. So here this another plain end, this is plain end, and this is plain end. So in the similar manner, I have indicated plain ends on the plain ends indicated here, and similarly on chord ends, on first pick a continuous float, just leaving the vertical space. These are reserved for wedding. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Don't count this one. Similarly here, just assume that wedding ends are absent here and indicate the first chord on the first two picks. And similarly, second chord on the third and fourth pick. So far I have just copied the view which we have taken plain face in 16 cross 4 and indicate the plain view here. So here plain view, one down, one up. Don't count this, one down, one up. Don't count this, one down, one up, and one down, one up. Similarly here, one up, one down. Don't count this, one up, one down, one up, one down. Forget that wedding ends are absent, just for time being. And here again, one up, one down. Don't count this, one up, one down. Don't count this, one up, one down. One down, one up. We will not count this. Then one down, one up. Don't count this, one down, one up. In this way, just I have indicated the plain face with just assuming that these wedding ends are absent. Now we will indicate the wedding ends. And as I have shown you, wedding ends are up where the picks float at the back. So picks are floating at the back here. These two picks are floating at the back. So here wedding ends will be up. And here it is interweaving in plain order. So they will remain blank. So wedding ends are up here and down here. Similarly, here the wedding ends will remain down, and because the picks are floating at the back, so here we will indicate the, we will lift the wedding ends. So wedding ends are up where the picks are floating at the back, and wedding ends are down, blank means down, where the picks are interwoven into plain view. In this way we construct a wedded plain face Bedford chord. Now draft will be constructed in similar manner. First end from first hill, then next plain end, that is different. So second, this is first, and then last is from first. Two hill frames are for plain view. Then similarly, this is from third hill frame. This is next hill, fourth. Just forget about wedding right now. Then next is same as this. This is same as this one. Then just forget about this. Leave it, and again this is third and fourth hill frame. Similarly, this end require another hill frame because this is different from the previous one, and then another hill frame. Leave the wedding in this way. And now wedding ends, it is two up, two down, so it will require another hill frame here. So pass it from seventh hill frame. And this is again different from the previous one. It is two down, two up, require another hill frame, that is eighth hill frame. In this way we construct draft in eight hill frames. From this draft and design you can complete the lifting plan. Now one change in the denting plan. Again here this is plain ends from the same dent. Now we are having here eight ends. So in this case we will divide it by four, divide by two, so we will have four. So instead of three, here four ends will be dented together, here four will be dented together. Similarly here four will be dented together, and this is plain ends from the same dent in a similar manner. And there will be one change in the sectional diagram. Here in the same similar sectional diagram we will construct as we have constructed with plain face, but now we have to introduce wedding ends. So here this wedding end is coming after two chord, so it will be indicated somewhat here, and this next will be indicated somewhat here, and because these are thick, so they will be indicated little bit larger as compared to previous one. And similarly after two, just approximately here, and this will indicated approximately here, and they are coming between these floating picks and these picks which are interwoven in plane. These picks interwoven in plane and these are floating at the back. They lie between these two. So depending on the diameter of these, thickness of these, this portion will be raised or lowered. So if it is raised, means we are increasing prominence with the help of wedding ends. In this way we can construct a plain face wedded Bedford chord. Now one more modification is there, that is 12, another type of Bedford cord, that is 12 phase, and similarly 12 phase can be constructed with wedding, so that will be 12 wedded 12 phase Bedford cord. And another modification, that is they can be arranged, these cords can be arranged alternately. So we will take this, all these modifications in the next video. Thank you.